מי שאכל במקום אחד, קוף פעידה לצריף א', לקבוע ברכה במקום סעודה, you're allowed to set a blessing in the place where you ate. ועד כמה יכול לברך, until how much you can bless, ומי ששכח ולא בירך, הוא בא בסדר, הוא לא פגר, אין בלס. זה סיק סיפי, א'. מי שאכל במקום אחד, צריך לברך קודם שיקום מקום. If somebody ate in one place, you need a bless before you leave your place. What about a big house? Can I leave one room, go to the other room, one corner, the other corner? Shnabo, mipin lepin afilu bayit gadol mutar. From one corner of a room to the other corner, even if it's a big house, a big hall, you're allowed. Ba'afilu k'shein oe mekomo arishon, even I can't see anymore, cannot vision anymore my original place where I ate. Kegon achore ha'paravan, behind separations of wood. Behind, let's say, there is a mechitza. Kayotze b'zeh. What happens if you have some kind of oinus? If he had some kind of a prevention, he couldn't bless the place where he ate. You're allowed to bless in the next room as long as you can see the place you ate. This happened to me just half an hour ago. I was very, very tired. I finished to eat. So I thought I will lay down and rest. Then I remember I didn't say Birkat Hamazon. So I thought, if I sit down in my bed, I asked my daughter to open the door, and I can see the place where I sat and ate. It's a different room, but I still can see the place. So I sat down, and I looked, I opened the door, and I saw my place where I ate. But then I remember that if I want to find a golden dove, I should get up. So I got up and I went to dove in the bench weapons. But really, mitzaladin from the law, you're allowed, as long as you see, you can vision your place.
Is this benching talking about Birkat Hamazon specifically?
Yes, Birkat Hamazon. Ve'im da'ato haya bishad Birkat Hamotzi levarech b'cheder acher b'bayit zeh. If originally when he said Hamotzi, when you wash your hands, you had in mind to finish to bless Birkat Hamazon in another room. Efshar deyesh la'akel bishat adchak, afilu lo re mekoma rishon. Possible. You can rely on this and say Birkat Hamazon in another room, even though you cannot see your original place. What does adchak mean? Like, for example, place is not clean anymore. So before you leave your place, you have to make a blessing in your place. Bet mimkom v'chol arba amot mimakom achilato chashim makom echad v'yuchal atik mekom adem minya ktana. Within 2 meters, where you ate, you can move for any other small reason. Ve'im, I'm reading back the Shulchan Aruch. Ve'im yatza mimkom v'lo birach. That's really what we learned yesterday. What happened? Open Mishnah Berurah, Kuf Pei Gimel, Kuf Pei Dalet Tzif Aleph. If somebody left the room and he didn't bless, Im Haya Bemezid, if it was intentionally, Yachzor Limkomor Vivarei, you have to go back to the place where you ate and you bless. Bet. Bet. Kuf Pei Dalet Seif Bet. So if he went out intentionally, you have to go back to your place. But if you already blessed in the place where you went out, and you remembered, you're exempt. V'dafka ledat Rambam. This only according to the Rambam's opinion. Aval ledat Rosh, according to the Rosh, the sphere that he holds. Da'af b'shogeg yachzolim kumo lechatchila. Even by mistake, lechatchila should go back to your place. B'meizid, intentionally, av b'dieved lo yatza. Even b'dieved not exempt. V'im haya b'shogeg, it was by mistake. La Rambam, yivarei b'chom shenizkar, you should bless the place where you remember. La Rav Rabbeinu Yoino v'arosh, you're touching your legs, you have to wash your hands. Or rub yourself. La Rav Rabbeinu Yoino v'arosh, gamu yachzor imkumo yivareich, also he should go back in the first place and make a blessing. Again. If somebody left this place by mistake, according to the Rambam, you don't have to go back. According to the Rosh, lechatchila you go back, b'dieved you don't need to. So it's a machloket. What's the halacha of betilel? Betilel, let's say, that b'shachach, b'shogeg, you don't have to go back. You don't have to go back, b'dieved or lechatchila. According to the Rambam, even lechatchila you don't have to go back. According to the Rosh, only b'dieved, lechatchila should go back. What happened if you went b'mezid? The same machloket. B'mezid, you have to go back. But if you left b'mezid and you forgot and you remembered after you made a blessing, the fact that you must go back and you didn't go back and you say the blessing, does the blessing is uprooted and it's finished, or you exempt the blessings? He says, according to the Rambam, it's okay. Because even b'shogeg, you don't have to go back in the chatchila. So b'mezid, b'dieved, if you already say the blessing, it's okay. But according to the Rosh, that even by shogeg, the chatchila should go back. So b'mezid, even b'dieved, if you already said the blessing, you're not exempt. Understood what I said? Mishnah Berurah. You have to go back. How much, what's the distance? You don't find David? So come sit here. You can sit next to Rabbi Ben Nachman Yosef, and he has a mishtabur. You look with him. Yachzor limkomo. You go back to its place. Va'afilu, I'm reading Gimel Mishnah Berurah. Va'afilu im gvar alach baderech lemarchok kama milim. Intentionally, you have to go back, and if you're blessed. Is a machlok of the yotze b'dieved or not? We said the Rambam says yes, the Rosh says no. How much? What's the distance that you need to walk that by intentionally we require you to go back? Afilu kama milim, even if you went a couple of miles. Imulosh urachok kol kach she'ad she'achzun kom itakel amazon nefzi barachol legamri. Evarech kan. This is what I told you yesterday. That if it's so far away that by you going back, that you figure it out, you estimate that your food is going to be digested by the time you come back. So when the food is digested, you cannot bless anymore. So there's no point of going back. But by you going back, your food is going to be still not going to be digested. Because we said 72 minutes is a small eating, like Tosfos.
So 68
But
minutes.
If you eat a lot, it's more. So if you measure that the time you go back, your food is not digested yet. So you should go back even if you went many, many miles away. For example, if somebody went to Bnei Brak by car, Tel Aviv. How long it takes to drive to Tel Aviv? 1 hour. You remember that he didn't say Birkat Hamazon. And before he left, he remembered that he has to go back. He says, I need a rush. And then he forgot about it and he remembered again. He says, well, what I did. I left intentionally. So now he ate a very big meal. If he goes to Tel Aviv, he still comes back. If food is not going to be digested yet. It's not 72 minutes. It can take him 2.5, 3 hours to be digested. So as long as the food is not digested, by him coming back, he has to come back. And even if he blessed, according to the Rambam, he's not exempt. So he said, you have to go back intentionally, and if he blessed intentionally, you exempt the coin to the Rambam. The coin to the Rosh, you're not exempt. What's the halacha? Mishnah Berurah Siv Katan Hei. Ulinan, and then the last three lines. Ulinan halacha iskimu achonim. According to the halacha, the later rabbis agreed. The ain tzarich lachzor levarech afilu haya bemezid balicha ubibracha. You don't need to go back and bless, even was intentionally by walking and by blessing. Kaniskar le'el b'siv katan dale. So the halacha is that the mezid, you have to go back, but if you did and you made a blessing, you exempt at the end. Even though it's a machloket rishonim, you exempt. And by shogeg, definitely you have to go, you bless in the place you remember. However, mikol makom gam le'azuim chazar hazeh meshubach. Everybody agrees that if you go back is the best. El adeinu mechuyah b'adamah, you're just not obligated. But really, lechatchila, you should go back. V'katvu al achonim deken achon lirog lemaaseh. This is what person should do. Lemaaseh, go back. Im lo shushat adchak, unless it's a time of narrowness. Da'az yuchal ismoch hasvara rishona, then you can rely on the first opinion that by shoyged, even lechatchila, you don't have to go back if it's a narrow situation. What happens if you go back, you lose davening, you lose vasikin, you lose something, you're looking, something mitzvah? So Reb Chaim Kanievsky says, they should go back to your place and still bless. Until they bring down here. Bet. Okay, so lemaise, what we learned. If I ask you lemaise, somebody ate and he forgot and he left the place he ate, always best to go back, and if he didn't, if you forgot, it's okay. And Bemezi, you should go back. Obligation, if he did, and he made a blessing, is also okay. That's Lamaisa. Claro? That's it. Bet.
You went
to Tel Aviv. But the Eved, if you made a mistake, Lechatchila, you go back, but the Eved is okay. Amazing, you must go back.
But if he said,
but if he made a broch already, so it's okay, you accept.
It's 2 hours.
What? You have to go by Mezid, you must go back. What's the amount of time, the distance that you have to go back? If the distance coming back, the digestion of food is not finished yet.
It's more than 72 minutes.
Whatever it is, and then you have to go back.
But 172 minutes hits, that's it.
You ate a small meal. After 72 minutes, the game over. Said, bless at least a place you remember, because otherwise you're going to lose it. By you trying to come back, by the time you come back, the digesting of the food will be going away, so you can't make a broch anymore. So make a blessing where you remember. Stop where you are and make a blessing.
Okay. Rabbi, assuming the 72 is expired, what's the status of the motzi? Does that have any status of a levat chol?
The ma'isi lechem. If it's already finished, it's gone. Yes.
No, I'm saying the ma'isi lechem, the initial bracha. For
if somebody
what's the status of that?
If somebody paused in the meal 72 minutes, and the food is already digested, if he wants to eat more, he has to wash his hand, make a new birkas ha'motzi, and then when he makes birkas ha'mozon, he exempts both foods, both 7 eating. That's what you're asking?
No, I'm asking if the 72 is expired, would the hamoitzi have a status of a levatola?
No. You ate. All right.
That's what
you ate, but the borkas hamoza cannot be said.
It can't be said.
And you have to, when you wash your hands, make a hamoitzi. Then you say because hamoza, you have in mind to exempt the original because hamoitzi. That's what you have to say. So let's see bet. Bamed dvarim amorim, shulchan aruch bet. Those words have been said when כשאין לו עוד פעם, he doesn't have more bread. אבל אם יש לו עוד פעם, but if he has more bread, Yochal v'makom asheni me'at. He should eat in the second place a little bit. V'yivarech and bless. Rak shelo yirayim ma'achila ha'shona. As long as he's not hungry from the first eating, so that he lost it. So, the way that if somebody left, we have to go back if he finished to eat.
Grab something else to eat.
But if he grabs something new to eat, so then you don't have to go back.
And shtia can't extend the
suda. Not shtia, eating.
I'm saying shtia can't extend the suda.
No. He says even parperet and kisanim doesn't help. Parperet means other foods other which foods. Are not bread.
Mizonos.
Or mizonos is not another way. Mishnah Bura Vafilu Bechet Vafilu Bemezid Meani Aitakana Shukalkan Mead Davar Muat. The answer to the Tchila Birkat Amotzi ulo Birkat Amazon al Masha Achal Kvar. Vachal Achila Pat Shebekan Birkat Amazon Be'ele Achila Shachal Mokom Acher. He says, since doesn't matter, even if he left intentionally and the food is not digested yet, and you want to eat again, so then you eat again without any amotzi, because the food is not being digested, and it never took your mind away from the original food.
And you start to
because you went out intentionally.
Does this mean that he didn't end his session?
He didn't finish his session, so he left intentionally. So the fixing of eating a little bit of bread helps to fix. The amotz in the original Birkas Hamazon. Mm-hmm. Now, but if you remove your mind, so everybody says you have to make a bracha again, a moitzi, and then when you say Birkat Hamazon, you exempt the original eating and Birkat Hamazon as well.
That's pretty cool.
But if you didn't remove your mind, you left intentionally, so you're not going to bless it away, you didn't remove your mind away, so in a new place, you can eat. So bottom line, all the halakha, this is a big chidush of Rabbeinu Peretz. Rabbeinu Peretz is basically minimizing all this halakha. He says, all machloket bet shamay bet hilel, you go back, you find golden dove, online, who eat you up. All those halakhot is what? When you left intentionally, you must go back. When you left by mistake, it's good to go back. Or if you made you don't need machloket. That's only when you finish to eat. But if you have some bread to eat, you can fix it by bread and eat it right there. It's a big shaila. So why Abba Balachana didn't fix himself? Maybe he needed more bread. More bread can fix himself. But that's what he said. That's what Rabbeinu Peretz. And that's the halacha. The Mishnah brings down. Me'at ayinu afilu pachot mikazait. Mikol makom itzarev zeh la'achila shecha makom harishon. However, this is attached to the original eating. V'dafka makom asher yachal gam ken pat. Only if you eat bread. But mezonos or other stuff, other dishes, says even kazait, it doesn't help.
It has to be another portion.
Right. It's not considering extending the meal. Rak, however, shelo yirayev, shouldn't be hungry. Mishnah Berurah says, Yud, deinu raev lo me'anim ashuchal ata, if he's hungry, doesn't help when he eats now. The kvar ifsid birkat amazon shachila rishon, I really lost the birkat amazon of the first eating. Kemar katu b'seifei, v'atau chiyuv chadash, there's a new obligation. He must make a new blessing on moitzi. So if somebody leaves his place and his hunger went away, is digested food, he's hungry. Again, so he lost. So he can never fix with nothing. Or if somebody left and he had intention, if he lost his mind of the food, he see achda, so then he has to make a moitzi again, he lost a blessing. But if somebody didn't lose his mind, his das, and he left intentionally, so he needs to go back. But if he has bread, right there, he can fix it by eating a little bit of bread, and without even a moitzi. And finishing the blessing of Avikat Amazon there, and exempts the original eating. Yes. What?
He just answered.
Good.
As long as he's still hungry.
Yes. Gimel. This is the Rambam. Yes, Omrim, or those who say, שכל שבעת המינים טעונים ברכה לאחריהם במקומם. ויש אומרים לחמשת מיני דגן דווקא, זה מחלוקת רמב״ם אין ראש. רמב״ם holds all seven species, dates, datilas, figs, fuego, all those, this one of fuego is fire. I know, but that is a, where did he say figs?
Eagles.
How about dates? How do you say dates?
Datilas.
I want to know. Datilas. Granada. I got it, right? Yes, all seven species require bracha lachem bimkomam. All seven species require a blessing in their place, you must go back. And if he left as the same halacha, b'shogeg, b'diyevi, you have to go back. Chatchila, you should go back. Machloket. And b'mezid, you must go back. And said, you're saving. What's the halacha? It's machloket, yesh v'yesh. V'ayin le'el siman tkufa inchet zifei, sh'sham ivi arav, od shita shlishi, d'davka bepad. The third opinion, only bread. So we have three opinions. Only bread, even five grains, or all seven species that the land of Israel has been blessed with. Shulchan Mishnah Berurah says, Sif Katan Yudbet. Uli'inyan Dina, what's the halacha? There are three opinions, what's the halacha? Katav Shama Gra, the Gom even wrote, Da'ikar, the main, Kedei Ashnir, like the middle opinion, the Chameshet Min Edogon Chashive Kepat Linyan Ze, five grains are considered bread for this. And if he ate mezonos, you're not allowed to leave the place where you ate. And the mistake, you don't need to go back, and then she must go back. Look, we wrote in Mishnah Berurah there. And he wrote that some achronim says, lechatchila, when you ate dates and seven species, things like that, you must place in your place, don't leave. Same thing if you change the place in the middle of the eating, you don't need to make a new blessing on them, because like bread. But the Goyim Vilna argues there, and he holds that Shiva Saminim is like any other fruits. The halacha is only like the second opinion, bread and Chamesh Saminim, fruits at all, not even Chathila. So you lost a blessing if you left.
By the way,
but if he left by mistake, I just want to finish. The Aruch HaShulchan says it's fake sfeika. You can bless it because maybe the halacha, you don't have to go back. And even if you do go back,
he's still lost.
Maybe it's by mistake, so you can say maybe the halacha, you don't have to go back, even l'chatchila. So that's why you bless in the place where you remember. However, the Ben Ishchai, the Sfaradim, the Ben Ishchai says that even if he left your place by mistake in the middle of eating those things, you have to go back and bless your place unless it's a narrow time. So it seems to me that the Sfaradim are more machmi. Because the Chatchila always is better to go back, so he says always go back. Okay.
Rabbi, yes. Is it entering Birkat HaMazon within the 72, or is it finishing?
What?
Is the Birkat HaMazon, does it have to be completed within the 72, or no, do you just have to enter Sei Hazanat HaKol?
Achal va Dalet. Achal v'no yodayim be'er Birkat HaMazon im lav. If somebody ate, and he doesn't remember if he made Birkat HaMazon or not, it happens to you? It used to happen to me many times. I don't remember if I said Birkat HaMazon. My house, my kids are running, screaming, this, that. I make Birkat HaMazon or not, I don't remember. I remember that I told myself to remember to say, but I don't remember if I said.
Sometimes in the beginning.
Tzarich levarech misafek, you have to bless from the doubt. Neishi min haTorah, because Birkat HaMazon is from the Torah.
Safek lechumra.
Safek lechumra, yes. That's only when you satisfy this from the Torah. Rachalta. Savata. If you're not saveya, if you're not satisfied, it's only rabbinic. However, Mishnah Berurah says, ומכל מקום יראוי לראי שמיים. It's better for somebody that has fear of Hashem when he has a sofek to be blessed or not, even if he only ate kazais. Very simple. Wash your hands. She told you, "Odo v'recha moitzi, make a new moitzi." V'rechal kazai, you need a new kazai. V'rechat amazon on both. That's the way to bypass it. Again, if someone doesn't remember if he had to send v'rechat amazon, what he has to do? Is to go back and bless Avigdoraita Lechum, even the fourth blessing. And even he can exempt others that ate and didn't bless. Because the Maisa, that's the halacha he has to do. But it's only when he's satisfied. When it's not, there's only rabbinic. So what he should do, he should eat new bread and exempt. That's a bypassing.
If he's still hungry. How do you know if you're hungry?
How do you know you're hungry?
It's also another shaila, man, because of the savata part. Like, you like the chewing, but you... That's why we're all...
There's an app.
That's why we're all pigs.
Asks questions, and then you...
It's not an app. He was talking about savata a couple of nights ago. That we're actually blessing the taste on the palate.
How do you know if you're completely full?
How do you know if you're completely full?
Oh, okay.
I didn't know it was such a simple question.
Okay. What about what did I say on the tilat yadayim? You have to become moitzi, but not washing it. Not to bless on the washing. You have to wash it and say, "Amoitzi," but you don't say until that's a dime on the washing of the hands. This is a safek. Hey. Ad ematai yachol levarech. Until when he can make a blessing. Ad sheitakel amazon shebeav. Until the food gets digested in the stomach. Vekama shuor. What is the measurement? Kol zman sheino raeh mota achila. As long you're not hungry from that eating. From the moment he became hungry, even though it's not totally digested, we judge it like it's totally digested. Same thing as eating fruits or drinking wine. He's not hungry, not thirsty for those fruits. He make a blessing. If you don't know, if you don't know the measurement, if it got digested. So Mishnah Berurah Sif Katan Chaf explains, if you ate all what you required from the bread or fruits, then the measurement is as long as you're not hungry. If you ate a little bit, avil machal me'ad v'chavetz lecholot. You ate a little bit, you want to eat more. And ashalai aloter means you just didn't have more, so you ate what you had. So it's very hard to measure when you're not hungry, because originally you weren't satisfied totally. Vazek Hashem ola sheru shachat. Se kevan shalom, since you saw la ta'ava. And ashalai aloter, you didn't have. Katu abe achonim sharim azek kedei luch arba minutin. Arba minin shu ayin bet minut. Then you measure 4 miles, which is 72 minutes. Until that time, you must bless. That surely, for sure, the food was not digested within 72 minutes. Which means if you ate a full meal, it's not 72, like Tosfot. It's as long as you're hungry from not eating. Not hungry from not eating. But if he ate very little, because it means he didn't totally satisfy himself. So it's 72 minutes. V'yesh min ha'achronim shebetzadedim. Now, some of the later rabbis take aside. De'im achal achilam mu'ed v'shakonim shebegat ha'mazon. If you ate a little bit, and you pause before you bless b'kat ha'mazon. Ve'inor yodeh l'sherim mitakel ha'mazon. You can't measure if you're still hungry. You stop thinking. Hungry or not, you can't figure out your stomach, right? Afshu betoch shiur arba milin, even if it's within a time measurement of 4 minutes, within 72 minutes, lechatchila, he should eat bread again. Yochal oto, yochal kopanim ot kazait pat, eat another kazait pat. אחר כך ברכת המזון, then bless ברכת המזון. ועל אותו פת שוכן אין צריך לברך המוציא, he can make a mozi on that. מחדש, אם לא עושה את אומר לכו, if you need to push your mind away from eating. So you just eat bread, again, מכל מקום אם אין לו פת, however, if you don't have bread, you can rely on the 72. יש לו הברכה הראשונה, לברך ברכת המזון שהוא רם המילי קנה. So again, if you ate a little, you didn't totally satisfy the 72 minutes. If you ate a full eating, it's as long you're not hungry from that eating. If you cannot, you need enough food, but you cannot figure out your stomach. So there's a way to bypass it. If it's within 72 minutes, eating bread again, you don't make a bracha. But on the safe side, you ate again, now kazayin, so you make a bracha on that. But to say nu bracha v'amoyitz, you can't, because it's in 72 minutes. The main halacha is that you don't need to. But on the safe side, you eat another bread. If you don't, you rely on the main opinion that even a little bit of eating 72 minutes, within 72 minutes, you didn't lose the blessing. But if you eat a lot, it's much more than 72 minutes. Yes?
You count the time from the moment that you stop eating
yes.
the bread?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
And not knowing means that you're clearly not full.
Vav, we finish with this.
Shi'ur
achila lebarech lebrikat hamazon. How much we need to eat in order to make brikat hamazon bekazayit? It's not so simple. Let's see. Av al gad debarach rishona tzir barei afil al kol shu. Even though the amotzi, you have to make a blessing even al kol shu. Also, there you're not allowed to make any. You're not allowed to pleasure anything in the world without a blessing. But in order to say Birkat HaMazon, you have to eat kazayit, anu mid Rabbanan. Aval midoraita nochal lebarei brachah anu kishachal dav kishuk sviya. But from the oraita, it's only when you eat the measurement of satisfaction. Shem achal dav sabata. It's very important. We'll see soon. I want to say a few points about it. Vishiyu sviya, how much is a measurement of satisfaction? It's not equal to each person. Each one knows his own satisfaction. Everyone has a different stomach. And if somebody only eats just enough to survive, that's considered for him satisfaction. And he's obligated from the Torah. If people like me, I'm talking about you guys, and you should feel good about yourself. And you always love to fill your stomach till then. Try it lately, not so, but I want to lose weight. But in concept, I always like to eat until I'm full. So until I'm not full, it's not full. So that's a bad. So kazayit, I need already say Birkat HaMazon from the rabbis. But from the Torah, is v'sabata. You have to eat kedei sviya. Sviya means satisfaction, you. Not other people, you. What it really makes you to be happy? Three slices of pizza? Five slices of pizza? Pizza pie? Two pizza pies? Depends on what's the size, right?
A good size of pizza.
Good size of pizza.
From New York. It's got to be very good. Better be very okay. good.
I don't want to Texas.
Oh, they do it.
Okay.
They do it up.
But depends on you, okay? Not on others. I want to talk about a few details about it, very important details, okay?
By the way, if you can't find that extra,
my father bless his memory. What do you want to say?
If you can't find that extra pot of lechem, are you in the category of shogi?
There's no shogi in the oven. There's no lechatchin in the oven. If you ate just kazayit, you make enough to bless it, but you should know you only obligated for the rabbis. If you have a sofik, if you say the kalamazon, you don't say. But sofik the rabbanan and kula.
I'm saying there's no sofik.
If you satisfy, you obligated from the Torah. So if you have a sofik, it's
you're not satisfied and you have no sofik.
If you're not satisfied, you know something. Vale, you make a problem. Not a problem. Now, in order to make an after blessing by kazayis, even from the rabbis, you need to eat the kazayit within time measurement of bichdei achilav pras. How much a long time period it takes to eat a half a loaf of bread, which is some opinions 2 minutes, 4 minutes, or 9 minutes. Three opinions. Otherwise, you cannot connect the beginning of the eating of kazayit to the end of the eating. In order to bind the whole eating of kazayit, to bind it together, you need to eat it within time period of a chidechil aspas. But satisfaction, that doesn't need 9 or 8 or 4 2 minutes. Even if you ate a long time, you had a long meal, and you ate and you drank and you sang, but the end you're full, your stomach can't move. Full. But that's the way, a normal way of being satisfied. You eat little. This is what Prime Godim says. However, the Mishtabur has a suffix in Prime Godim that could be even Chir Doraisa, because a Mozart needs Gidre Achila, needs rules of eating. Because besides satisfaction, you need Achalta Vesavata. So the Savata has to come through eating. And without having Achila Kazais within Achila Pazavashabachil, which means if I ate very little, but I never ate Kazais within time period of Achila's Pras, but I ate a meal in 2 hours and afterwards I'm satisfied. But I never ate together, and with all 2 hours, I never ate one kazait within period of Achilas Pras. Shkoya, this little ones, the midgets. That's the New Yorkers, right?
No, New Yorkers don't.
Right. Okay. Oh, I'm joking. Right? So he says you have to have at least kazais. And then the rest you can eat little by little. This is what Chofetz Chaim says. Because of that, my father bless his memory, every time we ate a meal in Shabbat, what did he do? You know what he do? He did is, he gave everyone kazait, and he didn't allow nobody to speak in the table until they finished right away to eat kazait. You understand me, Yosef? Right? Said my English?
Yes.
He didn't allow nobody to speak. Eat kazai, don't speak until you finish to eat right away, because then you divert your mind. Within 2 minutes, eat kazai, and you can talk what you want, words of Torah, whatever you want. Why? Now that you learn this halacha, you know why? Because in order to be obligated birkat hamazon from the Torah, you can be spread out for 2 hours. But at least you need one kazait, b'chidachilat pras. So that's why in the beginning he made sure that we eat kazait. And if it's worse, if we weren't satisfied in a meal and you didn't eat kazait, you're not obligated to say b'chidachilat pras only from the rabbis. It's worse.
You have to be satisfied
from the Torah, and even for that you have to have at least one kazai within Achilas Pras, within 9 minutes of eating. Arav Shmuel Zvozner Zicholivon says that a child that ate a kazai more than time period of Achilas Pras, like more than 9 minutes, he still can bless, he can rely on those on holds that you should say Birkat Hamazon always. Oh. One was thirsty, he finished eating, he's still thirsty. There is opinions that holds when somebody finishes to eat and is too thirsty, he's not obligated to say Birkat Hamazon from the Torah. So not only you have to be satisfied according to your satisfaction, it has to be also not thirsty. The Ramos says later on, unless yesh oimrim, that you're not obligated because of the Torah if you don't drink. The Chazon Ish wrote, if somebody was thirsty before Birkat Hamazon, after Birkat Hamazon he drank, even after some time, he needs to bless afterwards from the Torah. Because Birkat Hamazon that he blessed before that was not obligated from the rabbi, so that is obligated to him. This happened to me many times. And I always remember the Ramon, but I didn't know this Chazon Ish. I remember the Ramon. The Ramon says, if you said Birkat Hamazon and he's too thirsty, don't drink right away after he finished the food. After you make a Birkat Hamazon. Why? Because then it looks, you go into the machloket that some say that if she's too thirsty from the meal and you're now drinking, so he said Birkat Hamazon midarabanan, now you drink, you have to get from the Torah, you have to make a new Birkat Hamazon. So what I do is, always I wait a minute or two, and I'm very thirsty, and then I drink. But I see now, according to Chazon Ish, would help. Because as long you're thirsty before you said Birkat Hamazon, even if you drink after some time, would help you. You must still make a very big chiddush to Chazon Ish. Wow, you know this chazonish. It's a big chidush. I never did that. I just wait a few minutes. Like the Ramos says, don't drink right away. You know, I was thirsty. From before you said Birkat HaMazon, I was rushing. I was like, obey Birkat HaMazon. Wait a minute, Rabosai never ate. I read, but we really have so thirsty. So I knew if I drink right away, I get into the machloket, according to the Sarajva, that I now I need to bring Birkat HaMazon because I wasn't totally satisfied. Because satisfied is eating and also drinking.
Just take a big slug before benching.
I know, but sometimes you don't have the time. Right, right, right. Then you want to drink. So I was worried. Like the Rabosai said, I waited a while. The Kodesh Hazanish doesn't help you to wait a while as long as you were thirsty from before. Birkat HaMazon. Big chidush, big chum of the Hazanish. Makes life very hard. So you have to, mamash, go thirsty for a long time. Really long time to separate it, put your mind away from the eating, and then drink.
Did you see the video of the
Hazanish? It's a hard one.
Video of the Hazanish, did you see it?
No.
Then you have the same question, by the way, with thirst, because some people have dry mouth, some people are constantly thirsty, right. People that drink seven bottles of soda.
Okay. I want guys to make a review of this siman. Okay, there's more siman, we didn't learn everything, but at least this halakha, it's clear to us.